M-E-T-H-O-D, man. M-E-T-H-O-D, man. Hey, doing guys? Z4CK from YouTube, TV Nation Tech TV here. I've gotten a request on how to set a Velocity Gangstar, how to go through the settings, what they do, etc. Here's your standard Velocity with big shells, crown, and I put the Gangstar chip in there. And here's how you set it. First thing you do, there's a little button right here. It's the button that you have to be very, very careful with when you're assembling it, because you don't want it to break off. If it does break off, then you can just replace it with a big button, which is, I'll go ahead and include a link on how to do that. But here's how to set the settings. First thing you do, push down on this button. You'll feel it click. And turn the switch. You'll get red. Red is the force mode, so how much force you want on it. This has six modes. There's NPPL mode, which is, it'll put zero force on your balls, so you know, you don't want to overfeed them, you don't want to put too much tension on them unless you're shooting fast, like in unlimited ramping, which I don't see why anyone really needs to do. But NPPL mode, which is a very, very good mode. I like that mode a lot. So set it into NPPL mode, which is the first one. You hold it until it flashes once. There's NPPL mode. See? Zero force on it when there's paint in it. Alright. Now, to set it again, we'll go back to red. My favorite mode is called Regressive Tension 1, which is the second setting. So what you do is you hold it until it flashes twice. One, two. There you go. You're now in that setting. So, now, what this setting does is when you have it on, put your finger in there, it'll put tension on it, and the tension will just regress till nothing. Good thing about that is you will not get any skip shots, period. It's great, great mode. Now there are other modes in it, including Regressive Tension 2. Regressive Tension 2 is the same thing as Regressive Tension 1, except for the fact that it'll keep tension on it. It won't go all the way down to zero, it'll go down to one. And then the next ones are, 4 would be ramping, which is, it uses iLogic to tell your learner to go faster when you're shooting faster, slower when you're shooting slower. It's a good mode, but it wastes batteries. Next is reball, probably one of the better reball loaders, which it uses its iLogic to reverse and speed up when needed. Then there's PSP mode, which every time you shoot, it'll feed in a 3-shot burst. And if it can't feed 3 balls, it'll put on tension. So it's great, great X-ball and PSP mode. Your next setting is orange, which is the speed mode. I currently have mine set at about 4. Set to 4. You don't want to be really putting on too much tension, or you don't want to be wasting batteries. Batteries are expensive, especially if you're playing semi like I do. Next mode is tension, which is green, and that can go from 1 to 20. I don't like having any tension on there. There's really no need unless you're trying to shoot fast, and if there's really isn't anyone who can shoot more than 15 balls per second in semi-auto. It's just how it is, so there's really no need to be doing that. Now, next mode is red and green flashing. That is your breakout mode. So at the beginning of the game, when you turn on your hopper, it'll put it in breakout mode. Now what that is it puts full tension and full speed on to the balls for a certain amount of time, depending on what setting you have it on. It goes from 1, which is off, to 6, which is 6 to 15 shot delay. And basically, just putting tension on your balls at the breakout, because you want to be laning at the breakout, especially if you're a back player. If you're a front player, don't use this mode. Your next mode is orange and red flashing, which is the anti-jam, which it waits if nothing is seen by your eyes. but there's something blocking the drive cone, it'll wait for a certain amount of seconds and then reverse itself. Great, great mode. One is off, two is 1 second delay, three is 2 second delay, four is 3 second delay, five is 4 second delay, six is 5 second delay. Next mode is energy saver, which is green and orange flashing. On means that when the battery life is less than 25%, then the loader will change to NPPL mode, which is great because you don't want your hopper to be going down in the game. It's horrible. One is off, two is on. Now, when your batteries are low, what'll happen is the LED will turn red. That means it's less than 25% battery left, and that's, you want to be changing your batteries. Now I'll go ahead and show you what Gangstar spin mode is. You have it on. It's on regressive tension, right? That's the reason it stopped putting tension on is because it's in regressive tension mode, which is my favorite mode. Now, you can force the drive cone to go forward. It's an electric rip drive. So press the button. You just drove the drive cone forward to help prevent any jams. I'll go ahead and do a drop test, a free fall test. There really isn't a need for a free fall test. I mean, it doesn't really prove anything. Just like with the rotors, you can get 50 balls per second free fall, but you're getting 25 balls per second on a gun. It's really pointless, but I'll go ahead and show it off real quick. It's a full pod. Like my little hospital wristbands kid, huh? You can see, great fast hopper. The next video that I'll be doing is on how to change the settings on a Virtue Velocity.
Worse than ourselves, blind to the fact the whole time we were hurting ourselves. I used to wonder, I used to